from the holy book of French philosophy upon the thoughts of better men than us. We swear.
The whole thing started, you know, we're talking about 20 years ago with myself and John when we were in college. Heard about this competition to come up with a mural for the platform here. And we pretty much sat down in John's front bedroom and drew up the designs.
Had to be popular.
I mean, this is the thing, we came up with a design that was going to be colourful, appeal to people. You know, we were looking at stuff like Russian mural art, weren't we, John?
Yeah. Some nice, bright,
cheery, you know, big shapes, big figures and so on, so.
There's a little bit of artistic license, you know, to these.
In their inaccuracies, I think.
Yeah.
I think they're actually...
I know, and there's a few people have pointed out a couple of things recently, haven't they?
Anthony came in at a much later stage when we'd created Triskel. Anthony really was the one to sort of start the idea about refurbishing the mural and doing it in mosaic.
It's in a really, really terrible state.
I mean, if you can even point out there, John, the paint is being eaten away by salt, and it's wrecking it. Oh my God! You know, so it's literally crumbling away in front of our eyes, and this has been a problem over the last 20 years. We've been back to fix it, and it lasts about 2 years. It gets eaten away again, and you know, chemically, there's no way of solving the problem. So,
it's a losing battle.
What do you think? The other thing is you could introduce something into the sky.
Put it in the glass jar then.
A work of art. Oh, to be a work of art. But in time a thought comes tugging on the sleeve edge of our minds. Perhaps no perfect way exists at all, just many different kinds. Oh, but if it's just a thinner taste, then everything unwinds. For without an absolute, how can the absolute define a work of art?
So generally, I mean, we had a really positive response, but, you know, there were areas of contention, and one in particular being the offending panel behind us here. And originally the design depicted a Union Jack trailing along the ground.
Well, it had to represent that particular point in Irish history when the Irish took over from the English.
And the English were leaving, and we felt this illustrated the fact very well. But it seemed to upset a few people, and it became a contentious issue.
Well, we came up with the compromise of a bulldog, more subtle representation of the British Empire.
I don't think it was subtle. I think, you know, it's funny that the solution we came up with was probably more jingoistic than the original.
It's a big operation.
There's a lot to do, really.
There's no fiddling.
Yeah.